Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dealing with difficulty regarding being negative all the time. Some people are indeed negative. Anything that happens, they think of the worst case scenario and they live with that type of understanding. Now, bear in mind, we are human. It's normal to be negative, but it's also normal to be positive and to strike the balance. Try your best to strike the balance. Don't look at everything in a negative light. Something happens that is good and you just look at the negatives. You know, you look at the ceiling and think, what if the ceiling drops? You look at a road and you say, what if this just cracks open and we all go in? You look at a building and you say, what if the building falls? You're flying in the aircraft and you think, what if this aircraft, this happens to it and that? Why think negative for everything? Okay, we're human. It may cross our mind, but understand, quickly lay your trust in Allah. That's the bonus of a believer. When you have belief in your Maker and you know He put you here in the first place, He will look after you. Then, subhanAllah, you will definitely be able to achieve so much of positivity. Because what you will begin to understand is, Allah's given me a capacity, He's helped me, He's provided for me to a certain extent, He's given me everything that I actually have, and whatever He's given me, my physical capacity, my intellectual capacity, my financial capacity, and so on, everything put together, I will do whatever I believe is best to protect myself and to be able to build myself in a way that is pleasing to Allah and will make my life on earth, which is temporary, easy. And then I lay my trust in Allah. إِحْرِصْ عَلَى مَا يَنْفَعُكَ وَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا تَعْجَزْ. Work hard towards achieving that which is beneficial for you. Seek the help of Allah and don't be lazy. Don't just give up. Keep trying. If something happens that is negative, then definitely it happened. We will rise to the occasion. We will do whatever we can. We try again. We are not going to be lazy and we're not going to give up. It's part of the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't look at every scenario and say, do you know what? What if this and what if that? It's a type of an anxiety. It can become a disorder where you might even require professional help. Nonetheless, in the deen and the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's provided you with a coping mechanism and He's given you something amazing. Connect with Him. Recite the Quran. Look at the meanings of the verses of the Quran. Take a look at the stories of the prophets. Go through them, understand them, see what Allah did for the people. And remember, challenges will always come in your life. You will always have certain things that will occur. But with the help of Allah, you will overcome every one of them. Allah says, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah does not hold a person or does not burden someone with more than he or she can shoulder. So remember, if Allah has put you through a certain challenge, it's because He knows you will cope and you can manage. Even if it's tough, Allah knows He's going to make you strong. Where were we? Have we not been through challenges? Have we not been through so much in terms of uncertainty, in terms of negativity? Where are we today? Did Allah not provide for us? Did we not come out of it? Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah Almighty. If we look at others, they are really struggling way beyond us. And therefore, we should accept that we owe gratitude to Allah because of whatever He's given us. In fact, if we want to fight that negativity, one of the ways, yes, we lay our trust in Allah. Yes, we believe. Yes, we pray. Yes, we read Quran. Yes, we engage in what is known as dhikr, the remembrance of Allah. Because Allah says, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, I remember you. Get acquainted with Allah at times of ease, and Allah will get acquainted with you at times of difficulty. All of this is there. Remember, Allah Almighty has favored us. He will definitely grant us ease and He will help us to cope. He will open the doors for us. We have to have that conviction. So this world is made up of so many different things, different types of people, different days, the days that were difficult, days that are filled with ease. Allah carried us through to this day. He will indeed carry us through to even better days by His will. And that is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for us to constantly think about negatives is definitely a quality that needs remedying. Allah Almighty wants us to thank Him. He says, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you are thankful, I will grant you increase in goodness. And if you are going to show ingratitude, then I will definitely, meaning then my punishment is severe. He didn't say, I will punish you. But He says, remember, my punishment is severe. وَلَإِن كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And if you are ungrateful, indeed my punishment is severe. He didn't say, I'm going to punish you. Because sometimes Allah's mercy dictates that He gives you some time. And this is the beauty of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He won't punish you immediately. In most cases, Allah will give you a long time to repent, to turn, and so on. Sometimes He might choose to give the punishment earlier. Remember, gratitude is positivity. Ingratitude is negativity. And also, positivity is to show gratitude, and negativity is being ungrateful. So thank Allah. If something out of human nature happens to come in your mind and you think of the worst possible scenario, thank Allah. I mean, you're a human, so it's bound to creep in now and again. I'm sure it happens to all of us, but it depends how long you dwell on it. If you dwell on it too long, you become a burden upon those whom you live with. You become a person who's difficult to interact with. You become a negative force that people around you feel very low when they're in your company, because you only think of negatives. You have to push yourself to look at the positives and give people hope and have hope yourself. It won't happen, inshallah. It's possible that a fire might happen. So we have extinguishers, we have fire hoses, we have hydrants, and everything is there. But inshallah, it will not happen. Chances are 1 in 1,000,000. Every time we jump on an aircraft, they make an announcement and they tell you about the oxygen in case the oxygen fails. They tell you in case there is emergency, this is what you should do. They tell you in case landing, emergency landing, this is how you open the emergency exits, and this is what you should look at, and this is what you should do. Yet 99.99% of the flights land safely. Alhamdulillah, it's not because they are negative. It's not because they are struggling or suffering. It's only a normal thing to give you precautionary measures, let you know about them. So alhamdulillah, in the same way, we find Allah Almighty is kept within us a mechanism such that when you think of what might happen, there would be a few negatives. Don't dwell on them. Prepare for them and move on. Prepare for them. Be ready. Inshallah, look, I've got this and this and this in place. If something happens, I've prepared for a rainy day. It may happen, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to continue. So some of these topics are interconnected because they happen to all be remedied by the connection we will be having with Allah Almighty. And this is the mercy of Allah. When we're connected with Him, all the sicknesses, all the diseases, all the negativity, all the anxiety, sadness, whatever else it may be, jealousy, hatred, everything gets remedied because that is Allah. The connection with Him has a holistic growth of positivity that human being will always feel and appreciate. You will build yourself into such a lovely person by the help of Allah, with the connection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You begin to appreciate that connection and you start enjoying your prayer and your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us all ease. May He make us able to look at things more positively than negative. May He make us a force of positivity. And we ask Allah to protect us from the harms of this world and the next. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.